Hello and welcome to Reality News Roundup. Here are the top stories of the day. The Labour Ministry recently eased the planned restriction on withdrawal of contribution to the Employees Provident Fund. The Ministry has allowed withdrawal for housing, major medical treatment of self and family, medical engineering education of children and their marriages. The relaxation has also been extended to the members who have joined an establishment belonging to or under the central or state government and have become a member of Contributory Provident Fund or Old Age Pension. These norms will come into effect from August. The contentious Enemy Property Amendment and Validation Bill 2016 will come up before a select committee of the Rajya Sabha today, where a number of states are expected to express their views. The panel has been tasked to scrutinize the bill and submit its report in the opening week of the next parliament session, which begins on April 25. LIC Housing Finance reported a rise of 19.5% in its consolidated net profit at 1,667 crore rupees for the quarter which ended on March 31. The company has posted a net profit of over 1,395 crore rupees in the corresponding quarter previous fiscal. New Delhi's Leotin's Bungalow Zone, arguably India's most privileged urban enclave, is set to shrink. Dismissing objections from prominent Delhiites, the Delhi Urban Art Commission has recommended exclusion of 8 super posh residential areas from the Leotin Zone. This means relaxations of the floor area ratio for these soon-to-be ex-Leotin's addresses and the possible arrival of high-rises in areas known for grand low-rise residences. The Tony neighborhood houses the country's political super elite as well as residences of some of the India's richest business barons. Thank you for watching. For latest updates, follow us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram.